We rehearse the songs and we come in the morning and I forget them. I have so much going on other than music, so. Vamos a orar, hermanos, vamos a orar por la ofrenda, vamos a orar por los ofrendadores. ¿Todos dieron? ¿Los que trajeron? If you got a job, brother, you better give something to the Lord, amen. God's going to take that job away. God's going to take that blessing back, amen. If you don't acknowledge who's blessing you, amen. You know God can do that. Vamos a darle al Señor y vamos a orar. Amen. Let us pray. We're just going to get into God's word. Esta mañana. Vamos a orar. Padre, gracias te damos, Señor. Gracias por esta ofrenda que se ha recogido. Damos gracias por los hermanos que en su corazón han sentido traer, Señor. We just thank you, Father, for those who in their heart are about to bring a portion, Lord, of what you have blessed them with to give to you. I thank you for our brothers who gave yesterday, Lord, for completing this job that was being worked on, Lord. I thank you, Father. We know it comes from you. We give you all the glory. Toda la gloria, toda la honra para ti, Señor. Es tu obra. This is your work, Father. Estamos aquí en tu nombre, reunidos en tu nombre, escuchando tu palabra, cantándote alabanzas a ti, Señor. Todo es para ti. It's all for you. Can you turn around and tell somebody? It's all for Jesus. Turn around and tell them. That's right, brother. We don't do this to we're not giving any person any kind of recognition. It's all for him. Todo es para él. Amen. Un aplauso a Cristo. A él no es por él, pero he's still the last. Si no fuera por el Señor, todavía aún estaríamos perdidos. ¿Verdad que sí? Estaríamos todavía en nuestra vida antigua que vivíamos antes. Pero un día llegó Cristo y nos encontró. Toda honra y toda gloria para él. Amen. Amen. I have a message I want to preach to you that the Lord gave me a few days ago. And actually, last week I told you I had three, but this is one of those three. Amen. And I wasn't sure where to go with it, and I believe that the Lord finally showed me. So hopefully we're going to find out. Amen. Genesis chapter 2. Let's go to Genesis chapter 2. Vamos a Genesis capítulo 2. Genesis is one of my favorite books in the Bible. And I'm going to do something, brother. That, don't get offended. I'm going to do something. Chapter 2, verse 8. And the Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had formed. What did God do? ¿Qué hizo Dios? He planted a garden. ¿Cómo dice en español? Plantó un huerto. Plantó. Now let's go to verse 15. Vamos al versículo 15, ahí mismo. Ese capítulo. And the Lord God took the man and put him into the garden of Eden, that garden that God had planted. He put the man there. What did he put him there for? To dress it and to keep it. God planted. Man's job was to keep it, to dress it. That was his job. Amen. Dios plantó el huerto. El trabajo del hombre era de guardar y cuidar de él. Amen. Amen. Vamos a orar. Father, we come to you once again. We love you, Lord. We thank you. Thank you for all my brothers and sisters that have come here this morning. I thank you, Father, because that you put in our hearts, Lord, the desire to come and seek your face, to seek your presence, to hear from your word. Bless each and every one that is here. Bendice a cada uno que está aquí. Desde el más pequeño hasta el más grande, Señor. Y que tu palabra, Señor, haya lugar en nuestros corazones esta mañana. Lord, I pray, Lord, that you will just find a place in our hearts this morning. To the one that is seeking, to the one that probably came here with no intention of seeking, Lord, that even then you can speak to this person. And we may walk out of here, Lord, filled with your word, filled with your presence, and rejoicing in the name of Jesus. We come against all the work of the enemy. We come against all trouble that he tries to stir up in our midst, Father. We bind him and we cast him out in the name of Jesus. Lord, we just ask you to just take control right now. In the name of Jesus. Señor nuestro, amen. In the name of Jesus. You may be seated, amen. I've had a very interesting week. I'm going to say that much. And I ask for your prayers, amen. That's all I'm going to say about that. Amen. Almost every principle that God has established can either be found or traced back to the book of Genesis. Todo principio que Dios ha establecido puede tiene sus raíces o puede ser hallado en el libro de Génesis. Everything, really, everything. It's found in the book of Genesis. False religion in the book of Genesis. False worship in the book of Genesis. Idolatry in the book. There's everything, really. Todo tiene sus raíces en el libro de Génesis. La adoración falsa, la idolatría, todo se encuentra en el libro de Génesis. Tiene sus raíces ahí, ¿eh? Entonces, miramos en el capítulo 1 la creación. We see in chapter 1 the creation. And so I know that there are scientists and there are people today who study the earth and they study the universe, and they've come to so many different conclusions as to the origin. Hay muchos científicos, doctores y gente que estudia el universo, estudia la tierra, y han llegado a diferentes conclusiones acerca del origen del universo y de la tierra. But the Word of God makes it very simple. The Word of God doesn't go through all that phony baloney. It just goes right in one verse. It says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
Amen.
That's it. ¿Verdad? Es todo. Dios no le da la vuelta a todo como los libros científicos y da una explicación larga. Dice simplemente, en el principio creó Elohim los cielos y la tierra.
Amen.
You either believe it or you don't. Amen. Lo cree o no lo cree. Amen. But so that there would be no question as to who is responsible for the universe and the creation, we see in chapter 1 of the book of Genesis, over 30 times it tells us it was Elohim that created it all. Para que no haya cuestión acerca de quién es responsable por la creación, en el primer capítulo, más de 30 veces menciona a Elohim como creador. Amen?
Amen.
Now, it's interesting. I'm going to show you something. You want to see something interesting? Because Brother Martin likes to go through a lot of different things.
Amen.
You want to go just a little bit deeper?
Yes.
Say amen.
Amen.
You want to go just a little bit deeper? This is not even part of the message. Are you ready? Esto no es siquiera ni parte del mensaje. Ahí les va. There's something interesting about the book of Genesis. And it is that it says, en el principio creó Elohim. You read to the whole chapter 1, it dice, y Elohim creó, hizo el firmamento. Everywhere in chapter 1, it says, and God called the firmament. God said, let there be water. It says, God said, God blessed him. God saw that it was good. You notice it says God. That's Elohim in Hebrew. Till you get to chapter 2. Let's go to chapter 2. Hasta que llega uno al capítulo 2. Versículo 4. Let's go to verse 3. And God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, because then he had rested from all his work which God created and made. Now go to verse 4. These are the generations of the heavens and the earth when they were created in the day that, listen, now it changes. It doesn't say God. Now what does it say? ¿Qué dice ahora? The Lord God. Amen. ¿Se fijan? Ahora es el Señor Dios. Amen. Adonai Elohim. Now it says Adonai Elohim. Keep reading and it says Adonai Elohim and Lord God and the Lord God. Notice it changed from God to the Lord God. Verse 4, versículo 4, está hablando del nacimiento, el origen del cielo y la tierra. Porque en el principio, cuando Dios los creó, el cielo y la tierra estaban en armonía. Estaban en pacto. ¿Amén? Adonai es el Dios, es el nombre del pacto de Dios con la tierra. That is God's covenant name with the earth, with man. So that's why it changes to God, God, God. It says the Lord God, because now God is in covenant. Now heaven is in covenant, is united with the earth. Porque ahora el cielo y la tierra estaban en conjunto, estaban unidos. But you want to see something? Let's go to chapter 3. All through there, the rest of chapter 2 and all of chapter 3, the Lord God, the Lord God, the Lord God. Okay? Verse 22, chapter 3, verse 22, capítulo 3, versículo 22. And the Lord God, Adonai, Elohim, Said, behold, the man has become as one of us, knowing good and evil. And now lest he put forth his hand and take also the tree of life and eat and live forever. Therefore, the Lord God sent him forth from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from whence he was taken. Versículo 23, that's the last time it says Adonai Elohim. It goes back after that, it goes back to Elohim, just God. You know why? Because when God banished man, the man and the woman from the garden, their covenant was broke. Porque cuando Dios echó fuera al hombre y la mujer, habían quebrado el pacto. So no, it was no longer Elohim. Adonai Elohim. Ahora era solamente Elohim. Because they broke their covenant. Do you understand that?
Amen.
It's interesting, huh? How God puts his little details. Como Dios pone estos detallitos en las palabras. ¿Sí lo entendieron?
Amen.
Amen. Now look at chapter 3, verse 1. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field, which the Lord God, here it is, Adonai Elohim, had made. And listen to what he says to the woman. Ye hath, what did he say? Did he say the Lord God? He said, has God said. Why did he not say the Lord God? Because Satan is not in covenant with God. Amen? Porque él no está en pacto con Dios. Él no pudo decir Adonai Elohim. Dijo Elohim. Because he's not in covenant with God. You understand that? The little details. Esos detallitos en la Biblia. I hope everybody understood that.
Okay.
Amen? Pero, anyway, that's aside. That's just, I like little details like that.
Amen?
Amen? But I think it has something interesting. Amen? So, God, when he created the man, he was in covenant with him. And it says, the Lord God, el Señor, no sé cómo dice en español, ¿qué dice? ¿El Señor Dios o Jehová Dios? Jehová Dios dice, ¿verdad? En español. En el capítulo 2, ahí, toda esa parte del capítulo 2. Right, that one says?
Jehová Dios.
Jehová Dios, sí, okay. Amen. Amen. And it says that God planted a garden. Dios plantó un huerto. Now the Garden of Eden, let me tell you something about the Garden of Eden. The Garden of Eden was not small. It was not some little bitty garden where el jardín de Edén no era un jardincito chiquito ahí donde había unos tomates y unas cebollas y cositas así. It wasn't just some little garden with a little bit of tomatoes and one, carrots and onions. It was so big that four rivers came from it. So it was a huge, huge place. Era grandísimo, porque dice la Biblia que ahí salía un río y se hacían cuatro ríos ahí. Entonces era un lugar muy grande. It was a very big place. It was not just a couple of acres or just like your backyard at home. It was enormous. It may have been hundreds of thousands of acres. I don't know. It was huge. But the Garden of Eden was more than just a place where there were trees. Beautiful trees. The Tree of Life was there. The Tree of Life gives out 12 different kinds of fruits. Not one. Ahí estaba el árbol de la vida. El árbol de la vida dice la vida que da 12 frutos. No uno. Y los da cada mes. Eran árboles hermosos. Some Jews say that the tree of life went all the way up into the sky. I don't know if that's true or not. But it was a beautiful place. Un lugar muy bonito. Y ese lugar lo plantó Dios. Y luego dice que después de que lo plantó y todo estaba listo, dice que entonces puso al hombre ahí. After God planted the place and he got everything ready, it was in that he put the man. Doesn't it sound like what Jesus said in John chapter 14, where he said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. ¿Verdad? He said, when it's all done and ready, he says, I'll come back so that where I am, you will also be. Amen? God prepares a place before he puts us in. Dios prepara el lugar antes de ponernos ahí. So he planted a garden. What does it mean to plant something? ¿Qué quiere decir plantar algo? It means to establish something. To secure something in its place. Something that is planted does not just remove itself and replant itself somewhere else. ¿Verdad que no? Right? Algo que es plantado no se saca a sí mismo y se vuelve a plantar. Right? A tree cannot plant itself. It has to be planted. Un árbol no se planta a sí mismo. Tiene que ser plantado. ¿Estamos escuchando?
Amen.
Así que Dios plantó el jardín. He planted a garden. Had it all ready. It was a beautiful place, a great place. He put the man in there. He puso al hombre ahí en ese jardín, en ese huerto. Amen. I don't know what it was like, but I'm sure it was very beautiful. Yo creo que era algo muy hermoso. No sé cómo realmente cómo era. But it was planted. It was established. Everything that was there was meant to stay there. Lo que fue plantado ahí, la intención era que ahí se quedara. You understand that?
Amen.
And then he put the man there. Y lo pone el hombre ahí. And he gave the man a job. He said, I don't know, your job is not to keep it. I prepared it. Everything is here. All you have to do is keep up with it. Cultivate it. Cultívalo. Trabaja. Todo es tuyo. Puedes comer de cualquier árbol. ¿Verdad? That's all he had to do. Era todo lo que él tenía que hacer. You know, brothers, sometimes I think that we don't understand what it means that when God plants something, he wants to establish something.
Amen.
I think sometimes that's why some people don't make it in church. They come and they leave, they don't come back. They get discouraged very easily. And I was meditating on about this all day, and the Lord spoke to me. He said, because those people are not planted.
Amen.
They go to church, but they're not planted in the church. They will not allow themselves to be planted. Amen?
Amen.
Por eso hay gente, hermanos, que va a la iglesia, pero no duran porque no son plantados. Van a la iglesia, pero no están plantados en la iglesia. There are people that go to work, but they're not planted in their jobs. They just go to work.
Amen.
You see people, you ask them, hey, how's that job going? Man, they don't care. They don't know. 10 years from now, they don't know where they're going to be or what they're going to be doing because they're not planted.
Amen.
Amen? It's the same thing in a relationship, in a marriage. Why do a lot of marriages fail? Because they're in a marriage, but they're not planted in the marriage. Porque hay matrimonios que fracasan. Muchas veces porque los que están en el matrimonio, el hombre y la mujer, no están plantados en esa relación. Ahí están, pero no están plantados. Amen. And God plants something. He wants to secure it. He wants to establish it. A tree cannot uproot itself and plant itself. It must be planted. See, God has a place to plant you, to put you. And I'm talking about a relationship where you work and where you worship. I'm going to ask you, are you planted in those three today? ¿Estás tú plantado en esos tres lugares? ¿En tu relación, con tu cónyuge, en tu matrimonio? ¿Donde tú trabajas, donde sacas para darle de comer a tu familia? ¿Estás plantado? Y tercero, en el lugar donde tú adoras. ¿Estás plantado? ¿Are you planted today? ¿O are you just there? ¿O más estás ahí? I'm just there just to see what happens. ¿Verdad? Well, if you're there just to see what's going to happen, but you're not going to last very long. Si solamente estás ahí, no vas a ver qué va a pasar. No vas a durar mucho tiempo. Te tienes que plantar. You have to allow God to plant you, brother. To establish you. ¿No me tiene sense? ¿Estamos escuchando? Amen. We must be what?
Planted.
When we don't allow ourselves to be planted, brother, we frustrate God's purpose for our life. And God has to work around our mistakes to get us back where he wants us to be. Cuando no dejamos que Dios nos plante, frustramos el propósito de Dios para nosotros. Y Dios tiene que trabajar alrededor de todos nuestros errores que cometemos para volvernos a llevarnos otra vez el lugar donde Él nos quiere tener.
Amen.
Amen. Very simple message, isn't it? But it's not very hard, easy to keep sometimes. Brother, we must allow ourselves to allow God to plant us. If you're in a marriage, brother, don't be looking for a way out. Look for a way to stay in. They asked this one Hollywood actress, she'd been married for almost 40 years to the same person. Le preguntaron a una mujer, una actriz de Hollywood, que tiene casi 40 años de matrimonio. You know, Hollywood, almost nobody ever last married there, right? A month later, ya se están divorciando, ¿verdad? En Hollywood no duran, se cambian de cónyuge con examen de calcetines, ¿verdad? One time I thought it was funny because Elizabeth Taylor was on Oprah Winfrey. That woman been married like 10 times. And this lady had the audacity to ask her, can you give me any, ¿cómo dijo? ¿Consejos? How do you say consejos? Huh? Advice on marriage. How the woman has been married 10 times can give you any advice on marriage? She's been married so much, brother, she's been married so many times she had rice marks on her face. Amen. Ya tiene como 10 veces que se había casado y le pregunta, ¿tienes un consejo para ayudarme en mi matrimonio? ¿Cómo le da el consejo si tiene 10 veces que se ha casado? Change it from there. And anyways, what was I going to say? What was I saying before? That's right, yeah. Oh yeah, the actors in Hollywood, sorry, we're not. Entonces they asked her, they said, well, how do you stay married so long? Le pregunta, ¿cómo duras tantos años casada? She said, it's simple. She said, I never left. Why? Because she's tied in that marriage, in that relationship. Está plantada, ella se dejó plantar en esa relación. Dijo, es fácil, dijo, es porque nunca me fui, ni me ha ido. Amen. We have to allow God to in your relationship, right? In your marriage, in your family, are you planted in that family? Or are you just there? Because sometimes, brother, it's easy. You can lose sight and you can lose track of purpose. Porque es fácil, hermano. Uno puede estar en un matrimonio por tanto tiempo que hasta pierde el sentido, pierde el propósito. Sometimes you forget why you married that person in the first place. No, mi esposa ya está, pero cuando la conocí estaba, pero ahora no. You weren't all that either. You weren't all that either now either. Amen. Amen. Tenemos que dejar que Dios nos plante. Let God establish you, brother. When you're married, your relationship. I'm not talking to boyfriend and girlfriend relationships. That's just puppy love right now. I'm talking about those people that are married and that are actually running a home. You must allow yourself to be planted. Amen. God planted you there. Now, what is your job to do? Dios te plantó ahí. ¿Cuál es el trabajo del hombre? Huh? To keep up with it.
Yep.
To cultivate it. To make sure that it continues. God put you there. He planted you there. That's where he wants you to stay. Si Dios ahí te plantó es porque ahí Dios quiere que te quedes. Nuestro trabajo es ahora de cultivar. Ese huerto. My job is not to keep this garden that God has put in it. You know, it may not seem like a garden, brother, but it is. Es tu huerto. Es tu jardín, tu hogar. Your home. Your garden. God planted you there. Your job is to keep it. Amen. ¿Estamos escuchando? Amen. It was man's job to keep things in order, to keep things together. And it's not always easy, brother. No siempre es fácil. Is marriage easy? There's some young people here probably thinking, man, if I just got married and had kids, I'm going to be the happiest person in the world. Let me tell you something. There's some married people right now just saying, man, if I could just get out of this marriage, I would be the happiest person. No. Let me tell you something, brother. You allow yourself to be planted where God wants you to be, that's where you're going to be happy.
Amen.
Dejarte ser plantado donde Dios te quiere poner. Entonces vas a ser feliz. Because God put man, where did God put man? He put him in the most perfect situation. In the great place. And let me tell you something, brother. God has put you in a really good place.
Amen.
You may not think so, you may not see it that way, but God has planted you where you are for a reason.
Amen.
Amen. He wants to establish something in you. Quiere establecer Dios algo en ti. Let's go to Psalm chapter 1, verse 1. Vamos al Salmo 1, capítulo 1, versículo 1. Salmo 1, versículo 1. ¿Alguien quiere leer ese versículo? First one. Somebody want to read that? But Sal, you, I don't understand.
Bienaventurado el hombre que no anda en compañía de malvados, dice, ni se detiene a hablar con pecadores, ni se sienta a conversar.
Bienaventurado, sígale, pues. You were blessed.
El contrario, dice, se deleita en la ley del Señor.
La ley es la palabra.
Y día y noche medita en ella.
No nomás los domingos. Día y noche. Not just on Sundays. Siga.
Ese hombre es como un árbol plantado junto a los arroyos. Llegando el momento da sus frutos y sus hojas no se marchitan. Y en todo lo que hace, prospera.
Amén. Cuando uno se deja ser plantado por Dios, tú eres bienaventurado, darás fruto en su tiempo, todo lo que hace prosperará. ¿Por qué? Porque nos hemos dejado ser plantados por Dios. When you allow God to plant you, God said, I will bless you, I will prosper you, but you have to be in the place that I've put you.
Amén.
Tenemos que estar en el lugar donde Dios nos plante. Bueno, no, los problemas que hay, hermanos, que se quieren plantar solos. And I'm going to tell you something, brother. I mean, I'm going to tell you, some people, they would rather be in a big church where you don't have to, you know, where everything's already there, everything.
Todo.
¿Quién no le gusta estar en una iglesia grande de miles de personas? Nomás llega uno y se sienta, ya está todo, everything's already taken care of. You don't have to worry about nothing. Right? It's a lot easier to be in a church like that than a church that's smaller like this. But, you know, I'm not saying we're struggling or we really haven't had any really, you know, difficult times, like I would say hard times. But, you know, we work for what we have. You know, it's a little bit harder. But who would want to be in a big church? ¿Quién no quisiera estar en una iglesia grande? ¿Quién no quisiera ser parte de un ministerio bien reconocido y bien grande? But maybe that's not the place that God is planning you. Amen. Quizás ese no es el lugar que Dios te ha plantado a ti. We have to be where God plants us, donde Dios nos pone. Amen. Dice, y entonces, dice, será como un árbol plantado junto a qué? Corrientes, arroyos de agua. Y da su fruto a su tiempo y su hoja no se cae. Y todo lo que hace, prosperará. I mean, you want to prosper. Say, brother, I'm doing good, but I'd like to do better. And then start planning yourself, brother. ¿Verdad? Estoy haciendo bien, brother, estoy bien, pero quisiera ser mejor. Bueno, entonces déjate ser plantado por Dios. Quit being double-minded. No seas de dos pensamientos, de doble ánimo. Plántate, deja que Dios te plante en tu matrimonio, in your relationship, in where the place of your employment. Because remember, God gave him a job. Dios le dio un trabajo a Adán. ¿Verdad? Keep up with it. It's your job. Man, this is our job. It's up to us. We got to keep up with our home. Esa responsabilidad está sobre los hombres. No sobre la mujer. The woman shouldn't have to be figuring out how to pay the bills, how to do all these things, how to get these kids in line. It's the man's job.
Amen.
You be the head. Sé la cabeza. Quit being the tail. It's time to be the head. Deja de ser la cola. Hay que ser la cabeza. Amen. God put the man and he gave him a job. Then he gave him a woman. Don't be looking for a woman if you ain't got no job. Amen. No ando buscando novia y mujer y no tiene ni trabajo. ¿Cómo la vas a mantener? You gotta remember one thing about women, brothers. Here's a little bit of advice, brothers, for you brothers that are dating or whatever. You younger men. There's a reason why women are called females. They're not free males. They're females. They come with a fee. They're going to cost you, buddy. Just from the head up, they're going to leave you broke. De la cabeza para arriba, hermano, con eso te vas a ir en cheque. They're expensive. Amen?
Amen.
That's true. Palete, lipstick, makeup, cabello, cejas, todo. No, hombre, la se me fue tan cheque la semana. That's why they're called females. Because they come with a fee. Not free, brother. Amen? So if you ain't got a job, brother, don't be looking for a woman. Get a job. Even if you're young, go work at United. Go work at somewhere part-time. Start learning how to make money and be responsible. Amen? So that when God does give you a woman, you're going to be in a good place. Amen? Amen. 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 refuse to allow God to plant us, we drift away further and further away from His purpose in our life. Cuando nos dejamos, hermanos, de dejar guiar por Dios, nos vamos a ir alejando más y más fuera del propósito de Dios. I'm going to show you something real quick, okay? Let's go to the book of Genesis, chapter 13. Genesis, capítulo 13. This is Lot and Abram. He's not Abraham yet, he's Abram. There's a reason why God changed his name, too, but that's another message. Amen. They have become so prosperous. Se prosperaron tanto. Is that AC on or is it the heater or something? What is that? Is that on back there?
Yes.
Where's that on?
It's on.
Is it supposed to be on? I'm just here. I thought it was here. I'm like, what is that? You can turn that off. I don't think we need it, do we?
Turn it off.
Yeah, just turn it off. There we go. Okay, just ignore that. My brother's working on the roof. I don't know what they did up there.
Sorry about that. So
we see Lot and Abraham, they're so prosperous that they can no longer live together. They have to separate. Lot y Abraham estaban tan prosperados, se habían prosperado tanto que no podían estar juntos, se tenían que separar. So this is what Abraham tells Lot. I want to show you something real quick. 13. Verse 6, and the land was not able to bear them that they might dwell together, for their substance was great so that they could not dwell together. And there was a strife between the herdmen of Abram's cattle and the herdmen of Lot's cattle, and the Canaanites and the Perizzites dwelled then in the land. Abram said unto Lot, let there be no strife, I pray thee, between me and thee, and between my herdsmen and thy herdsmen, for we are brothers. Hey, how many can say amen to that? We don't be fighting over petty stuff, brother. We're brothers. Is not the whole land before thee? Separate thyself, I pray thee, for me. Listen to what he says. If you go to the left, I'll go to the right. If you go to the right, I'll go to the left. That's Abraham talking. Now look at right here. Look what it says right here. I mean, look, he's like, versículo 10. Verse 10. Lot lifted up his eyes and beheld all the plain of Jordan. He went, that it was well watered everywhere before the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, even as the garden of the Lord was so beautiful, it looked like the Garden of Eden. The Bible says that Sodom and Gomorrah were so beautiful that it did look like the Garden of God. Even as the Garden of the Lord, like the land of Egypt, as thou comest unto Zoar. Then Lot chose him all the plain of the Jordan, and Lot journeyed east, and they separated themselves the one from the other. Abram dwelled in the land of Canaan, and Lot dwelled in the cities of the plain, and he pitched his tent where? Near Sodom. What kind of place was Sodom? It was a place that was entirely corrupted. That's where we get the word sodomy. If you don't know what the word sodomy is, look it up. I'm not going to tell you what it is. I don't even want to say what it is from up here. But that's where we get the word sodomy. And that is something God forbids. Understand that? They were so corrupted that they no longer married each other. They were just men with men and women with women. Multiples, orgies. They were so sexually perverted that God eventually ended up destroying both of the cities. Amen. Now, this is what I want you to see. Let's go to first Lot. He looked towards Sodom and he said, I want to go there. Looks exciting over there. So he goes over there and he pitches a tent. Now, let's go to chapter 19. Vamos al capítulo 19 de Génesis. Okay? Vamos al capítulo 19 de Génesis. Look at verse 1, versículo 1. Somebody read that real quick, please.
Now the two angels came to Sodom in the evening, and Lot was sitting in the gate of Sodom.
Okay, stop right there, brother. Okay. In chapter, what was it, 12, 13? Where was Lot? He pitched his tent near the city. Lot, en el otro capítulo, 13, que era, parece que leímos, Lot había puesto su carpa cerca de la ciudad de Sodoma. Pero ahora estamos en el capítulo 19. ¿Dónde está Lot ahora? He is at the gate of the city, so he's closer. Ahora está donde está el muro de la ciudad, las puertas de la ciudad. Fíjense que se ha ido más y más. He's getting closer and closer. Because, say right there, brother. Because when we do not allow God to plan us where he wants us, on our own, slowly we'll come, we'll start moving towards, further away from his intended purpose. ¿Entendemos? Cuando no dejamos que Dios nos plante donde él quiere ponernos, poco a poco nos vamos a ir alejándonos. Primero tenía una carpa, ahora está a la puerta de la ciudad. Keep reading, brother.
When God saw them, he rose to meet them, and he bowed himself with his face toward the ground. And he said, "Hear now, my lords, please turn into your servant's house and spend the night. And wash your feet, that you may rise early and go on your way." And they said, "No, but we will spend the night in the open square."
Read verse 3, brother.
But he insisted strongly. So they turned into him and entered the house, his house. Then he made them a...
They entered where?
His house.
Okay, so where is he living now? First, he was close to the city. He's at the gate. Yeah, he has a house. He actually has a house in the city. In what city? Of all places, Sodom, that was under God's judgment. Sodom was already under God's judgment. He was living there. He had no business living there. Lot estaba viviendo en la ciudad de Sodoma que estaba bajo el juicio de Dios. No tenía ninguna razón por estar ahí en esa ciudad. Pero comenzó de a poco. Tenía su carpa. Ahí está a la puerta de la ciudad y ahora tiene su casa dentro de la ciudad. Porque cuando no dejamos que Dios nos plante, nos vamos a ir alejándonos más y más. Hasta después estamos dentro de una ciudad, de un lugar donde no va a haber salida. And the only reason Lot even escaped Sodom was because the Bible says that God was being merciful to him. They had to get him by his hand and take him out. And the reason God did that is because of his promise to Abraham. Keep reading, man.
Then he made them a feast and baked them unleavened bread and their wings.
Amen. Who are those two men that showed up at Eve them? Who are those two men that showed up? They were angels. Look at chapter 18. Three men showed up at Abram's house. Two of them were angels, one of them was the Lord. The Bible says that the two angels left to Sodom and Gomorrah to destroy it. God stayed behind them and he talked with Abraham. Amen. So those two angels that were with the Lord continued to Sodom. Sodom was under God's judgment. Brother, you need to be careful because you could be sitting in a place that God has already sentenced to judgment. Because God has not called you to be there. You understand that?
Yeah.
Tenemos que estar donde Dios nos quiere tener plantados. Podemos que estemos en un lugar, hermanos, donde Dios ya tenga juicio sobre ese lugar. Y no estoy hablando de un lugar físico. You understand, brother? So how important it is that we allow God to plan us, and when God has planted us somewhere, we need to keep up with it. Love your family. That's why if you notice, I will tell you, when we cancel service for a reason, what do I always tell you? ¿Qué siempre les digo a ustedes cuando alguna razón cancelamos servicios? ¿Qué? Spend time with your family. No se vaya de callejero a ver para dónde voy. Pase tiempo con su familia. Be with your family. Be with your wife. Be with your kids. Spend time. I don't care. Rent a movie or something, but be together. Spend that time with them. That's your garden. This is the life. That's where God wants you to be planted. For some of you, this is your church. This is where God has put you. God has planted you here. Stay here.
Amen.
If you don't feel that, then I don't know. I can't make you. But if God has planted you here, then you're going to prosper here.
Amen.
Amen.
Si Dios aquí te plantó, aquí quédate, aquí Dios te va a prosperar. En tu matrimonio, en tu trabajo, that job that you have, God gave it to you. God gave you the ability and the skills to do what you do. God wants to plant you there. Don't just go to work, be planted in your job. Don't just be in your marriage, allow yourself for God to plant you in your marriage. Don't just go to church, allow God to plant you in your church so that you can be a blessing there. Don't just go there. See what happens. ¿Qué pasa? ¿Y cómo te gusta el trabajo, padre? ¿Nunca viste hermano que le dice eso? ¿Cómo que es tu job, padre? Does that sound like someone's been planted in their job? Or even cares about their job?
No.
Give them one chance and they're going to run. The same thing in your marriage. I bet you the brothers here have thought about it even. Right? Ooh, brother, taboo. We don't want to talk about that. Sometimes we need to talk about that. You don't want, I know you're not going to raise up your hands, but I bet there's some here that thought about leaving their marriage already. You may be thinking about that right now. All I got to tell you, brother, is if you got planted you there, you better stay there.
That's right.
Work it out.
That's right.
Because anywhere you go, it's going to be outside the will of God. C.S. Lewis put it like this. The step outside of the will of God is to step into nowhere. Amen? God wants us to be established. Planted firmly. God doesn't want you jumping around everywhere. Jumping around from church to church, from job to job, from relationship to relationship. God wants you planted.
Amen.
Because something that is not planted will not grow. Porque algo que no es plantado no va a crecer.
Amen.
Will it? You put a seed on the window, is it going to plant? Is it going to grow?
No.
Hey, 2 weeks ago I put the seed there, nothing. Because you need to plant it. Plant that seed in the back and put it by the window and you're going to see it grow. You're going to go through the process. Plant it for the big one. Sit down. What happens, brother, when we step outside of the will of God and we do not allow God to plant us? You run into so many hardships and difficulties. You're going to run into problems that God never intended for you to run into. Cuando no dejamos que Dios nos plante, hermanos, vamos a tener problemas. Problemas que Dios nunca quiso que tuvieras en tu lugar. Amen. You're going to say, man, I don't know why this is happening. I don't get it. Well, maybe you were never supposed to be there in the first place. You didn't wait on God. You didn't wait on the Lord. You didn't allow Him to plant you. You wanted to do it your way, and now you're suffering the consequences. No quisiste esperar en Dios. No quisiste que Dios te plantara. You took up before God even had a chance to get you the right place. And now you're suffering, and you're going through a difficult time. But let me tell you something, brother. Our God is a restoring God. And He can work. You can say, Brother Martin, I'm a mess. That's all right. Gardening is a messy job, but God's a gardener. He doesn't mind getting his hands in the dirt and getting a little bit dirty. He'll straighten your life up. He'll straighten everything up, brother. He'll make it brand new. It does not matter. Our God is a gardener. You ever notice in the book of John, the Bible says that when Mary came to the tomb, she saw Jesus, but she did not recognize him. Who did she think he was? ¿Quién creía que era Jesús? María, cuando llegó a la tumba, no lo reconoció. ¿Quién creía que era? She thought he was a gardener. Because our God is a gardener. He's in the business of planting, establishing. And He wants to plant you and He wants to establish you in the place that He chooses so you can be blessed. Él te quiere plantar a ti junto a arroyos de agua viva para que tú prosperes, para que tú des tu fruto, so that you will be fruitful. I don't have any fruit, but I have nothing to show for it. Tengo 20 años de trabajo y no tengo nada. I got nothing to show. I've been in this job 20 years. I got nothing to show for it. Maybe you were never planted there. That's why there's no fruit. Allow yourself to be planted in your relationship where you worship. And you're going to see that God is going to bless your life in a way that you never expected. Amen? You believe that? Okay. Amen. I'm going to invite you, brother, to come to this altar. I want you to talk with God. Él es el, ¿cómo se dice gardener en Spanish? ¿Jardinero? Jardinero, es el buen jardinero divino. Te quiere plantar. He wants you to be planted. He doesn't want you to live your life, end your days with no fruit, with nothing to show for it. Dios no te quiere que termines tus días solo. In a barren land with no fruit, nothing to show for it. 20 years in church, 30 years in church, nothing to show for it. You gotta let God plant you. It's not gonna plant you. I'm gonna put you in a good place. Come up in a lugar, man. I know what you need. I got the right place for you. I got the right job for you. I got the right mate for you. Just give me time and I'm gonna plant you. I'm with you. I'm working things out. I'm going to plant you, but when I plant you, you're going to be fruitful. Pero cuando te plante, vas a ser. And the good gardener, the Bible says that he comes and he inspects the trees to see if there's any fruit. That's one thing that Jesus will always do. He'll come at a season into your life and see, okay, where's the fruit? ¿Dónde está el fruto? I put this brother, yo puse a este hermano, a esta hermana en una iglesia para que crecieran. Ahora vamos a ver si hay fruto. Where's the fruit? I told him to keep the garden. I planted him. Everything was good when he got there, but it was his job to keep up with it. Su trabajo. De cuidar de tu jardín, de tu huerto. It's your job, brother. God is going to put you in the right place. But it's your job to keep it. Are you planted today?